was it like getting to work with all these kids?
Blessing. It's my second year, my own camp, and it's amazing to have all these kids out here. I wanted to learn, wanted for me to teach them. I want to thank their parents for actually bringing them. It's been a great day so far.
How'd you feel when the kid said he only needed $16 from you?
That's an odd number. I would have said any other number. But 16, I guess he wants $16. So, great kid. I was just having a conversation with him over there. Really smart.
You came in, obviously, last year, got this started. Now you're doing it again. You feel it's, your place here in the city is growing?
Yeah. I want to do so much for this beautiful city of Houston. They welcomed me with open arms. So, this is just the beginning, there's a lot more to come, but this is definitely a great step into my heart.
When you were younger, did you have any opportunities like this? Is that part of why you wanted to do that?
Yeah, I didn't really have a lot of opportunities like this, just to be able to go to professional basketball camp. At this younger age, I kind of learn the basics of basketball. So, I went the extra way, an extra mile, just to go out there and have a camp and make sure I can teach guys and girls the fundamentals of basketball.
So what did you do in camp? Like this, what are the opportunities?
There's no opportunities. It's just basketball and playing out with my friends or trying to find a way. As I got older in high school, I started going to clubs like that. But at a young age, at 8 or 9, I wasn't really going to play.
Does it kind of bring back the joy,
Yeah, I'm a kid at heart, so just get out here and kind of have fun, laugh, smile, kind of see the kids happy and enjoy yourselves. That's all that matters.
Has it felt like a particularly busy summer for you?
Yeah. I haven't been still in one place in like over a week, so just moving around. But this is the beauty of it. This is my job. This is what I signed up for. So there are a couple more days until I got to be in Chicago for USA Basketball and summer starts.
Even since just in the last couple of weeks, does it feel like your role with USA has changed a little bit, or how things are going to shape out?
Every day, every single day. I've had a couple talks with Coach K as well about my role. So now that Kevin's dropped out, my role's probably going to increase a little bit. But there's so many great, talented guys on that team that I don't have to push on myself. Anyone doesn't have to feel that way. So I wish I had a pretty good team.
How do you feel? Does it compare at all to what's going on here? You came here, and obviously you're a leader for the Rockets. Does it seem like they will be leaning on you in a similar way there?
Yeah. These last couple of years has been a whirlwind. I'm just embracing it. I'm embracing that, making sure I can put myself to the best and get out there having confidence and do my job.
That's kind of what you want when you're playing in whatever situation, Rockets or USA?
Definitely. And like I said, I've learned these past couple of years with Houston how to be a leader, how to take on that leadership role. So, there's an opportunity for you to
What were your thoughts about that? And then,
I was laying the ball up. I just turned around. I forgot whoever it was. I wasn't really sure who it was. I heard the crowd. So I looked at him and see if he was all right. And I looked at his leg and it was bad. I kind of walked away. But I talked to him a couple times and he's in good spirits. My surgery went well. He's back in Indiana, kind of relaxing and rehabbing. So. He should be all right.
You said the other day that maybe it was the worst thing you ever seen on a basketball court with your own eyes. Is it easy to get over that, get past that?
You know what? Any sport, there's a risk of injury. Obviously, that was a freak accident. But like I said, it'll be good. As basketball players and athletes, we're not trying to worry about getting hurt. We just go out there and do our job. So, like I said, it'll be good.
It's disappointing to see some of the media members make too much of Chandler and new stuff and trying to get into something like
that. Yeah, I don't feed. That's one thing I won't do. I won't feed into it. Me and Chandler have had plenty of conversations, especially in Vegas. We've talked. He definitely was overblown. I'm happy for Chandler. He's in a great situation. Nothing but the best of luck for him.
Did you even feel like you needed to talk to him there? Obviously, you're both there in Vegas. Do you feel like anything needed to be said?
No, it was normal. We talked about normal stuff that we used to talk about. Like I said, the media overblew it and kind of took it out of proportion. We really didn't even talk about it.
Have you paid attention to how much that's kind of happened this offseason? Almost anytime anyone said anything, it's been blown out.
Looking for something to talk about. that's what I expect. So I don't really focus on it. But I focus on what can I control and being a better person.
That's part of being part of a good team, though, right? If you're a good team, people start looking at things to pick at.
That's a good thing. That's a good thing. We're a good team. You know, we got a long way to go, but we're in a good direction. And hopefully, the guys are working this summer and preparing for the next season.
Thank you, guys. Sure.